Hey everybody, Ryan Marrinan here for 3M. Today we want to talk about some tips and tricks on how we're going to replicate the seam sealer bead, particularly on this Honda CRV. They have a little bit taller profile than what's considered standard, and we're going to show you using our products how we're going to replicate this. Let's head inside and get started. All right guys, so we're back on the vehicle here now. We've got our panel prepped, we've already scuffed our surface, and we've actually taped off our bead to the desired width that we want. What we're gonna try to do here is we're gonna replicate that original factory appearance. We're gonna do it just a little bit differently because Honda's got just a little bit taller bead than most other manufacturers. We're gonna be using 5887 here for this application. What we wanna do is we wanna start by equalizing the tip. And of course, we're always equalizing the cartridge in an upright position, preferably into a towel. And we just want to make sure we got equal parts of A and B have started out of the material, or out of the cartridge. Once we apply our static mixing tip, we actually want to dispense some of the material onto a mixing board to make sure that we've got a thorough mix coming through the tip. Typically, you're going to use about 2 to 3 inches long of a bead to make sure that it's mixed before we apply it to the vehicle. Once we apply it to the vehicle, we're going to start from one end and work our way around. If you notice, as I'm putting on my first layer here, I'm working it into that hem flange. It's important that we work it into the material, creating a tight seal on the surface. We don't need to be perfect with getting it laid out. That's what the tape is there for. Now we're going to do our first initial knockdown. Typically, how I'm going to do this bead is I'm going to start from one end of the door. I'm going to lay it out all the way around. This applies also to hoods and deck lids. Once I get it laid out, I'm gonna come and I'm gonna knock it down, and I just wanna knock it down enough to make sure that it goes all the way from tape to tape. If you happen to have a spot like this that doesn't go quite tape to tape, it's okay to come back in here again. Just lay it down a little bit more. Again, we're not trying to remove any material, we're just laying it down. So a tiny bit on the mud spreader is fine. We just don't wanna have a big glob here when we're done because it means we didn't get enough on the car. Once we've gone all the way around the vehicle and we've gotten, you know, to the end of our panel with knocking it down, we're gonna come back again, and now the material's had a second to sit. And this is important here, why we do this in two steps, because initially that material is gonna have an instant flow and then a slower flow. We want that instant flow to set out and get to the slow flow. The next material we lay on top is gonna give us that taller arcing bead. And what we're trying to do here is we're gonna just create it right down the middle of the panel of our taped off area. Again, it doesn't need to be completely perfect because we're gonna come back over with the mud spreader one more time. Now typically, depending on the size of the panel, if it's a large hood, I can start from one end and go right around to the other end. If it's a smaller panel like a deck lid, I might give it a second or two just to kind of give it a little bit of a flow, allow it to melt into that lower material underneath. Again, we're gonna just knock this down. And then we're gonna pull our tape off. Now it's important when we're pulling our tape off that we're pulling back against it, creating a nice clean cut edge. If anything with seam sealers, when we're pulling our tape, we wanna be inward just a little bit, not outward, so we don't create a wave that they can't get paint underneath when it goes off to the paint shop. So as we pull our tape off, we're focusing on pulling back against itself as we work our way around the door. Now when we get to the corners, depending on what the recommendation is per the vehicle maker that you're working on, they're gonna recommend that you pinch off the corners so that you have clearance for gaskets, but more importantly, we're allowing the water to get out from underneath that surface. And what this looks like is when the door, say this is a door panel and we're looking at it from an inside position facing downward, water is going to build up along this bead by pinching off the corners on our hoods or deck lids or in our doors. We're going to allow that water to sort of drain out naturally on the corners and out onto the pavement, not be stuck on the surface and not causing any corrosion issues or delamination of the paint if it's got some corrosive like salts and so forth mixed in with it that don't get washed off on a regular basis. So that's it for this bead here today. If you want other information about our seam sealers, check out more information at 3M Academy. The link for that is in the description below. Also, some of our other videos here on our channel. Hit subscribe. This keeps you up to date with what we've got going on. The notification bell will make sure that you're getting the most current information as we're releasing it. If you like this video, go ahead and hit the thumbs up down below. I appreciate you watching, and we'll see you guys next time.